Merry Christmas, Mr. Contreras!
We hope you have a really
great Christmas!
Okay, I guess that's all we need.
This kind of me, Ariana, I know it's been a while, but we need your help this year. Let me make this clear.
Okay, hey guys, I'm Zilan.
I'm Jennifer.
I'm Serene.
I'm Emily.
And we are the Cream Poofs!
Oh god!
Okay, so Jennifer, what do you think we should do for our project?
I think our essential question could be, how do certain demographics such as race and age could affect an individual's choice on like a certain coffee shop?
I think that's a great idea. I've always wondered why coffee shops tend to be so crowded. And we all know they're a popular location for studying or working, but why?
So the seven coffee shops that we chose are Chromatic, Pete's, Phil's, Starbucks, Tom and Tom's, Big Mug, and Voyager.
Okay, so let's round it. Okay, so we got 1, 6, 3, and 5.
Oh, that's Chromatic, Phil's, Tom and Tom's, and Big Mug.
Oh, we should do a cluster sample. Since we need about at least 40 surveys, we should get at least 12 individuals at each location.
Yeah, for our survey, we should ask for their race, gender, their age, the reason for them being there, the average time and money spent, and the reason for that specific coffee shop. And our survey looks like this. Okay, let's go, guys.
Oh, that was so...
Okay, so we just got our fills and we just finished surveying. That was very hard, but you know what? We're all done.
Thank God.
Yeah, oh my gosh.
Okay, so now we're back at Phil's and yeah, we're gonna get some work done.
So we're at Tom and Tom's right now. We just finished surveying for them and
we had some problems.
Yeah, okay, so basically this guy, I didn't want to be rude or anything, but he kept like talking to like his like group of friends and I don't think he wanted to be bothered, but like for our survey we do need like a like different
older people.
Yeah, yeah. We need like different age groups. Yeah. And so I tried to go up to him and I asked him, hey, could you like do our survey? It's just like a quick survey, it doesn't take that much time. And he was literally had like the rudest tone and he was like, no, we're busy. And I was like,
what the heck?
Yeah. Honestly, like at this point it's kind of like weird because
it's so awkward.
Yeah.
Okay, so we just finished sampling everybody. So we went to Chromatic and then we went to Big Mug, Tom and Tom's, and Phil's. And we're at Phil's currently, and right now we are working on our written report.
Wow, look at everyone.
Okay, typing so vigorously.
Yeah. So we sorted all our data onto a spreadsheet, and then we sorted by race, gender, age, the reason for them being at that specific coffee shop, the amount of time and money spent, and the reason for that specific coffee shop.
During our surveying process, Serene also mentioned that two males denied to fill out the survey for us and they were like 41 years or older, so that could be a non-response bias. And also we forgot to put in the option of Middle Eastern into our survey, so as a result those people who are Middle Eastern had to put it in the other categories, which could affect our data as well.
There's also undercoverage bias because we tended to approach people who looked younger and more friendly as opposed to older people, so we kind of underrepresented the older population in coffee shops.
Oh yeah, also I kind of just realized this, but like when we were surveying people, there were a lot of like females that we kind of wanted to talk to more, just because I think that was based off of our bias and we weren't really sure how to approach like a male individual without being really awkward with them when asking to do their survey.
Okay, so looking at the gender of customers that we had surveyed, as you can see in our graph, you can see that the female has about 51.1% and for the males it's about 46.7%. So the reason why the female has such a higher percentage is because we as a group felt more comfortable talking to female individuals because we are all female, as well as the rather not say, which was about 2.2%. And the reason for that was because some people that we had surveyed had actually not put any answer to our survey. So for instance, they did not circle male, female, or rather not say. So we had just decided to put them as rather not say.
Yeah. Okay, so the age range of customers, looking at the graph over here, so we realized that most of the people we surveyed were those like
those age 25 to 30. And like, I guess that reason, that could probably be like, because we've tended to go to people who are our age. So yeah, that could probably be why. That's why we only have like one person who are aged like 41 or older.
And I also found a connection between like the average money spent and the age. From this graph over here, I also noticed that people who are about older than 30 years old, they tend to spend more money, especially 31 to 40 year olds, because they have like a job and they're stable.
And as for count of race, we found that the majority of people at coffee shops were Asian, probably because places like Tom and Tom's and Big Mug are notorious for having a lot of Asian customers, and we live in the Silicon Valley, so there's a lot of East Asian and Indian people.
So we found a connection between the reason for being at that coffee shop and the reason for choosing that specific coffee shop. So those who tended to go to the coffee shops to study tended to prefer a better atmosphere, while those who went to hang out preferred better food. As seen in this screenshot of the spreadsheet, approximately 18 out of 31 people who chose to go to coffee shops to study or work valued the atmosphere over the coffee and food. Meanwhile, those who went to coffee shops to hang out preferred the location over coffee and food.
Oh, actually, I meant to say that they preferred coffee and food over location, so
my bad, Mr. Contreras.
So throughout our experiment, we encountered three different types of biases. The first one was undercoverage bias. The second one was selection bias, and the last one was non-response bias. So non-response bias is when certain individuals are unwilling or unable to participate in surveys, such as the two groups of older men that we approached who didn't want to participate. And selection bias is when we purposefully choose certain types of people to answer our survey over others. So for example, we tended to approach younger, more friendly looking people over like older people. And finally, undercoverage bias is when some members of our population are not equally represented, such as older people, because again, we tended to choose younger people who looked more friendly.
So we discovered that like majority of the people who spend the most amount of time there is like those aged between 19 to 24. They spend an average of 4.7 hours at coffee shops. But then those aged 31 and up, they spend like around 1.45 to 1.5 hours at coffee shops. So like that suggests that like majority of the younger population tend to go to coffee shops. And also when analyzing the reason for being there, we realized that those under 30 tended to go to coffee shops to study or work, which is probably what students and like those who work in the tech field do very often. But those over 30, they answer that they tend to go to coffee shops to hang out and just relax.
Overall, we found that the people at coffee shops tend to be between the ages of 19 and 24, so like college age, and they also tend to be Asian females.
Yeah, we have some sources of errors, like we had our own biases, like we tended to go survey people who are like more similar to us, like Asian females, like around our age, and that may have skewed our data.
In addition to that, when we surveyed all of the coffee shops, there were some people who didn't really know what to do, I guess. For instance, they didn't really circle the one right answer that they were supposed to. Instead, they either circled all of it or they circled none. However, with that in mind, we didn't exclude them. We still included them in our data, and yeah.
Overall, we had a wonderful experience surveying all these people, and now we know why people choose certain coffee shops.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
Okay, so we just found Corey. It's so cute. I don't know how to do this.
There is just one thing I need.
And then.
Merry Christmas, my dude. Okay.